In this video, I'm going to show a wonderful tool for teaching online. This tool is so versatile that you can use this tool both in online and in physical classroom environments. This tool has certain unique features which I could not find anywhere else in any other application. So therefore, stay tuned till the end of this video and I'm sure that you will find a great value in this tool. And we are starting right after this short break. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Tahir, and for someone who don't know me, I make videos about online teaching. I myself have many online courses on various platforms such as Udemy, Skillshare and some others. I also make videos about some of the subjects which I teach, and if you are interested in any of these topics, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell and turn on notifications on your mobile devices so that whenever I upload a video, you will get a notification. And I upload videos every Tuesday and Friday, 7 p.m. Australian time. The online tool which I'm going to show today is called Classroomscreen. And you can access this on classroomscreen.com. They offer two types of free accounts. One where you don't have to give them your email and you don't have to open an account. And if you want, you can also sign up for this free account. And my recommendation is that you sign up for this basic free account. They don't have any premium version at the moment, but on their website they mentioned that soon a premium version is coming. So hopefully we will get some more features in this tool. This tool has some unique features which can be used in classroom activities, both in physical classroom or in online classroom environment. And even if you are tutoring one-to-one, you can use this tool effectively for your online tutoring business. So now I will jump on my computer and I will show you what are these features. To start using this tool, you need to visit classroomscreen.com, and if you scroll down, you can have a look at their plans. This is what I recommended, basic with account. So you just sign up and then you will be presented with this page. And here I need to click on login and log in again. Then you will be presented with this beautiful screen, and you can change this background anytime if you want. At the bottom, there are many ways you can use classroom screen. For example, in a physical classroom, you can use this as a digital whiteboard where you can put certain tools available in this screen and you can train your students to follow the instructions. I will explain all these tools. Another tool you can use for doing activities is this traffic light tool. You can turn this light red, orange, or green. And based on the status of the light, you can instruct your students to perform certain activities. In order to close any of these tools, there is a cross button. Just click on that. Calendar is also available. And again, if you click on this again, you will see this settings where you can change the parameters of this tool. Let's say I change the background color of the tool if I want, or I can give it a specific color for the theme of your class if you have any. Similarly, you can also change the transparency of the color. And as you move this, as you can see that color transparency is changing, and because there is orange color in the background, the mixture of the color is showing up. So every tool has a setting icon on the right hand side which you can open, and then you can simply click on this arrow and this icon will disappear. Now let's close this tool. The next one is clock, which shows the time, and it is important sometime that you put this clock on your screen. Again, to close this tool, click here and then click on this cross. Then there is a stopwatch, which you can start from here and ask your students to perform any activity and note the time. Also, there is a timer. If I click here, now the time will start in reverse order. I can set any time. Simply click on this plus or minus, whatever you want, whatever minutes you want. And then you simply start the timer and it will start counting down. Then these are certain icons. You can drag any tool. When these double-sided arrow appears, you can click and you can drag this. Now these are certain icons which you can use based on the situation of the class. When you need silence, you can highlight this icon. If you want to allow the whispering, you can highlight this. Then there is ask neighbor, which is this one, and then The final one is work together. When there are group activities, you can turn this on your classroom screen. So useful. No, then there is a simple text box where you can write anything you want. And this is the whiteboard, and I will talk about this at the end. Then there is QR code. And if you type any website here, this will generate the QR code for that particular website. There are some very useful websites for students. You can send them to all your resources which you have collected for any particular subject, or you can send them to any YouTube videos. Just put the link of the YouTube video here, and they will scan this with their mobile phone or their tablets, and they will straight away reach the video website and they can watch the YouTube videos. So very useful. I have made a separate videos how to use QR codes for educational resources. You might want to watch that video as well. Then we have this microphone, and if you have a microphone available in the class, then you can set an acceptable noise level. Now the next one is this dice tool, and you have the ability to throw one dice, and you can just click here and it will throw a dice. You can click again and it will throw another dice. This is used for doing some activities in the class. You can throw two dice, and based on a particular number, you can ask your students to do a particular activity. Then this is very important that you can enter the name of your students here, and then, so let me drag here. And once I have entered the name of students, then if I click choose, it will randomly choose the name of a student. So this random name selection is important when you want to be impartial for selecting a particular student. Now the next one is background. And if I click on this background, now it will take few seconds to upload this background, but many backgrounds are available and I can select any of these. Most of the time it is good to select a plain background. So let us select this one. And now at the end, I'm going to describe this whiteboard functionality. And this is basically draw tab. If you click on draw tab, you will get this whiteboard where you can draw anything, and you can change the size of this board if you want. You can have another one if you want. And as you can see that now I have two. So this is very good tool for teaching mathematics and some subjects where you want to demonstrate something. Just select a pencil and then you can select any of these colors available. So let's say I select this blue, and then you can write whatever you want. Now if you want to number them, you can do this here. For example, you can give this any number. Let's say you give it number 4, and then you can give this number 5. So now when you click here, so in this way you can assign them numbers. And if I click on these settings, I have the option to change the background from white to, for example, let's say this lined background. And now the background is lined. Similarly, let's say I change the background of this from plain to a graph paper. So I can do that. Similarly, there are some other backgrounds available even for teaching music. You can select this particular background. So this is a very important simple whiteboard available here. It has kind of limited features, but it is very useful. You can open more than one screens by clicking on these lines. Then you can open a new screen. And when you open a new screen, you can again set the background to any other color. Let's say cyan. Then you can have some whiteboard on this screen. And at the bottom, you will notice an arrow will appear here. And if I click on this arrow, I can go back to my previous screen. So within the same tab, you can have as many screens as you want. And you can easily go from one screen to other by clicking on this arrow. So in this way, you can keep all your demonstrations or all your problems which you are solving intact while you are taking the lecture. You don't have to delete anything. So this is a very powerful feature. There is another feature which is a poll feature. You can click on these three lines and then you click on open a new poll. And here you can throw any question. And here, let's say you can ask your students about today's lesson, and they can vote here. So for example, let's say I click here and it's first vote. Then I click here one time, it's first vote. If I click here again, now this has two votes. Now two votes are yellow and one is green. If I click again, as you can see, the graph is changing. And if I want, I can click on these settings and it will show me the poll as well. So these are some of the useful tools available in Classroom Screen, which you can use both in online and in actual classroom environment. I hope you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching and see you next time.